camping. So, if you want to stop and camp, it's great. Nice and easy. If the wind is blowing and you want to keep your wheel back, you've got the right thing, no, I haven't.
Get it.
Start again. See, John has had some work on this. The tent is now ready, you can see the car. Obviously, I don't mean to show you the bed. It's up top, you can come and film them when you finish, but you can't get up. You can get your cupboards, all your cupboards are here, fridge, some extra storage. And if you need to go to bed, then you put them down and you climb up the ladder into your bed. Okay? Bolts. Bolting through from here, one on the front, one on each corner. We're keeping a box for the equipment for removing. So just to be safe, we drop that bolt into the box for now. Dion, the spanner does not fit. Okay. You don't want to lose that. You grab that short. Only on the grass and roll the top. Right, so now we must put the leg. This one is good. This is our shower cubicle. Oh, that's also great. Now this is for the shower curtain that will fit here. Alright, but we're not going to put the shower up now. Okay, in order to protect our floor, because we have a very good floor here, we're going to use some wood. Yeah. Ordinarily, these will be stored inside. There are numbers on each leg to match the number on the plate, so you know you have the right number. Box start with the front legs first. Then we go for the back legs after the first, just secure the top one, keep it in place.
Yeah. Now walk away from me, just try this electrical plug in again.
When you're going to drive off this camper, there's an electrical plug here that keeps the electric feed from the front to the rear, so you would need to unplug that before you drive off the camper. Another bolt through here. Around. I might need Dion. Just wondering if I have another cup screw like that, because where the doors are, I need a cup screw. I will put the other rear one on. I need the bolt, but I might be around here now a little bit. I think I might need a cup screw. Okay, so it's just wing nuts. Hold the legs in place. I do in here is a compressor that we will need just for inflating this unit to get them off. I'll show you now. Right, so we get all our legs now and we drop our legs to the floor. As I said, we're using the wood just to protect the floor. Normally there's a foot here, but we decided we don't need the foot, because the foot is designed for the earth outside. We're not using the foot. Now we just need the airbag off. Okay, so here we put our airbag. We connect our airline and we do the same on the other side. Thank you.
Ja.
Kann man schon.
Nein,
nein, stimmt. I mean, how do I... Did I change his leg, right?
No.
But that's physically not...
Yeah.
But, I mean, I've always put him in that problem. The brain is showing. It's my natural look.
Right, and again the air. Okay, so now it is in setup and position. We've unbolted it, so it's ready to lift. We take our compressor out of our bag. We have already a power point for our compressor here, so we can plug it in. And we already have then we have an air valve here for our compressor. Start to inflate. As we inflate, so you will see the gap is opening up. Because the vehicle naturally lifts to the back, so we want to get as much height as possible up front in order to allow the drive off to come all the way through. It's actually good to just move her a little bit when she's pumping, just to allow the leg to not catch with its skin. And we use the same valve. We plug him in there. Plug him in here as well, and we plug it left. Now, although it's lifting, so is the canopy, so the camper, so we have to get a bit more height. That should be it. Thank you.